Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्
If you take the ocean water in one cup, all the qualities of the ocean water will not be there in that one cup. Naturally, the life which is in the ocean, its contribution to that water will not be there in the cup water. But the Paranjyoti is a rishi who wrote, recorded this whole leelas. Paranjyoti was capable of bringing all components and dimensions of the ocean into one cup. He was able to describe so beautifully the leelas, I tell you, because the incidents themselves cannot capture the charisma of an enlightened being, an incarnation. the context in which the incident is presented, the understanding with which the happening is shared, that creates the inspiration in the next level human beings to raise themselves to that state. Please understand, Rasalila of Sri Krishna can inspire somebody to be a womanizer, can inspire some women to become beloved of Krishna. The context in which it is presented, the way in which it is shared, the way in which it is taken to human beings, the way in which human beings are taught, decides whether Rasalila is going to create womanizers or enlightened women. Whether womanizers are going to be created or enlightened women are going to be created will be decided only the context in which the whole story is presented. I tell you, Paranjodhi is the best biographer. He has done such a monumental work. I know for sure in front of him at least 100,000 incidents and the leelas would have been there. But he cannot record all the 100,000. People won't have time to read. He has to choose between that 100,000. He has to reduce the 100,000 to 63. Impossible. Which one you will leave and which one you will choose? I tell you, nobody else could have done better job than Paranjodhi. Each incident explains, expresses one extraordinary power Sundareshwara was radiating, one extraordinary experience Sundareshwara was radiating, an extraordinary capability Sundareshwara was radiating. Please understand, capability is not power. Capability is like a circus. By training, it comes. Power comes through training, but not by training. For example, you meditate, suddenly one day you start levitating. It comes through training, but not by training. Capability means you hang in a rope and try to do yoga, exercise, circus in that rope. By training, you master it so well. Just holding the rope with one finger, you are able to hang. This is capability. This comes by training. But you are meditating, suddenly you start levitating. This does not come by training, it comes through training. Means, even if you are getting trained, at one point there will be a breakthrough where beyond what was added will express. That is extraordinary powers. But Paranjodhi is not inhuman fellow. He does not record only extraordinary powers of Sundareshwara. He records extraordinary capabilities of Sundareshwara also. That is why that sweet human touch, where Sundareshwara goes and carries mud to embank, to build embankment for this Vaigai. This whole river itself is created by one of his disciple, follower, a Gundodara. The fellow ate too much, ate literally everything during the marriage festival. And he was having hiccups. And his hiccup was like a lightning attacking the whole city. Meenakshi got frightened. As far as I remember, that is the only time she got frightened. So Shiva said, all right, go and put your hand on the ground and water will come. And so Ganga immediately came and he drank the water and quenched his thirst, whatever. So to build embankment for this Vaigai, he has to carry the sand, all the problems created by disciples. For that, he has to carry the sand.
I know the modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering, opportunity to express leadership qualities, techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny, or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru, 9742203311.
Now I can understand, not just extraordinary powers, his extraordinary capabilities are also beautifully described by Paranjyoti. That is why the human touch, I tell you, just if you read the 63 Leelas, you will have feeling connection to Sundareshwara. This book is like a Kalpataru, because once you have feeling connection for him, he is not a philosopher, understand? All of you, if you remember, I took a vow in Kailash that I'll give whoever as whatever without judging. If they come in my breathing space and ask, it is given. Sundareshwara is that energy. And he will go to any extreme and take risks. As I said now, if somebody comes who sold all the wealth and drank and womanized, made 10 lakh debt, coming and asking Sundareshwara, I wanted to settle my debt and I want more money for womanizing. Give me few years of life also for womanizing. If Sundareshwara does not have this money, he will go and steal and bring and give. That is Sundareshwara's compassion. He will go in the night, literally using all his powers, open the doors, steal, bring it and give. There are 3 incidences where Sundareshwara went round stealing. Is recorded in Thiruvilayadal Puranam. The book describes his leelas. 3 times he went round stealing in his own city. He has not left anything undone. But I tell you, there was never ever the sweetest human dimension recorded about the divine without reducing the grandeur and beauty of the divine in the language anywhere on the planet Earth. To compile the incidents and experiences happened between me and my disciples, I don't think anybody else can capture that glory and radiate it through the muscles. So it's like a glory of the vast ocean and sunrise and the shining full moon and the huge Himalayas, the extraordinary Kailash, all these glories, the vast sky, all possible glories expressed in its purest form through the muscles is Sundareshwara. When he sits, it is Kailash. When he walks, it is tsunami. When he turns his eyes, it is eclipse. The beauty of the cosmos in flesh and bones is Sundareshwara. The description does not reduce the divine qualities and grandeur, but does not miss the human touch coming down to the ordinary level. He is not available only for pandits and the yogis and meditators. He is available to a drunkard, womanizer, pigs. One pig got killed in the hunting by the king. All the children of pig, what do you call in English? One person, piglets. All the piglets were crying. And he comes as a pig to feed them. God, I cannot imagine. I cannot even imagine this compassion. Means what? This whole area, he decided, in this geography, I'll be available throughout the history. And no philosophy. That is Sundareshwara. In this geography, I'll be available throughout the history without any hindrance of philosophy. Over. This is exactly the description of Sundareshwara. No philosophy restriction is philosophy of Madhurayadinam. That is the philosophy of Sundareshwara. Comes down, assumes human body, thus all legal, illegal, socially accepted, non-accepted, all types of leelas. Not just for his devotees, yogis, rishis, spiritual seekers, no. For drunkards, for prostitutes, for pigs. I can't even put a restriction. If you feel connected, only then he will come. No. I can't imagine pigs felt connected to Sundareshwara and they called, "Oh Sundareshwara, please come and give a milk." No. It is just causeless, purely reasonless. I bow down to the pure love and compassion of Sundareshwara. The four statements I wanted to make at the beginning of the satsang, I made only one statement. I'll make three other statements in next satsangs. Causeless, reasonless expression of the divine, not only in human form, in any form. He came down as pig, female pig. God, I bow down to his compassion and his grace. O Sundareshwara, let your grace be on all of us. I'll continue on my satsangs, on the philosophy and history of Madhurayadinam. It feels, let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974-22-033-11. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.